Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hello folks, this is Beston Slot with some brand new news and updates for Planet Zoo. We're going to be taking a look at three main areas today. We're going to look at some brand new animals that are getting added to the game, expanding the already huge confirmed species list. We're going to take a little look at a scene from a new trailer, which I'm going to also link in this video later on. And then finally, we're going to take a look at the results of a recent AMA. This is an Ask Me Anything. The developers of Planet Zoo, Frontier, recently did an AMA on the PC gaming subreddit, and we found out quite a lot of information we didn't have access to before, so I'm going to go through some of the more interesting responses later on into this video. First things first though, new animals, let's take a look. And the first of those new animals is of course the Gemsbok. It's a little hard to tell sometimes, we have an incredible number of African ungulates and African antelope and stuff like that in the game already. I kind of thought we already had Gemsbok, turns out I was wrong. But the Gemsbok has been officially showcased in that new trailer that you'll see a little bit later on. And it looks pretty good. I don't really know what else to say. It looks great. We are going to bring up a comparison image with a real life Gemsbok so we can get a better feeling for how well represented it is in the game. Now the lighting is a little bit different. Of course, it's definitely a warmer environment in Planet Zoo, so that'll excuse the colouring. But all in all, I will say it's a fairly on the point representation of a Gemsbok. The main thing, which for me for a Gemsbok, is the patterning. And yes, we're using a blue pen today. The patterning around the face is there and it's pretty much spot on. You know, the thick sort of little bouncy bit. I don't know why it's bouncy. Then the very thin line before it splays out beneath the horns. That is there and present on both of them. Looks like he's crying. That is there and present on both of them. That is decidedly a Gemsbok. You've got the huge, long, slightly curved horns. A big patch of brown in the middle. Sort of a black lining underneath. And then these kind of sort of lined striped legs with the black and white patterning down there. It's pretty on the spot. The Planet Zoo version, as with most of the Planet Zoo animals in the game, does look a little bit fluffier, shall we say. They tend to come across a little bit fluffy because of the fur shader. But beyond that, it's a pretty good Gemsbok. Not the most exciting animal for me personally. I recognize it is for a lot of people, and that it's a staple in zoos, and it's a very well-known African animal. For me, I want to see some slightly different things, some slightly more exciting things. I'm a little bored of the antelope, I'm not going to lie, or the antelope-esque creatures, but still, it's a good representation. It's definitely different in terms of size and stuff than a lot of the others, and it's definitely one of the bigger antelope we're going to have knocking around the park. For me, slightly more exciting is the next animal, though, the Cape Buffalo or African buffalo, depending on your preference. And there he is, a big chonking unit of a lad with, just look at the legs, those thighs, whew, who wouldn't want those wrapped around you. It's interesting, we're actually here in the Indian Scenario Zoo. This is the one I played with when I was over in Gamescom. We didn't have access to the buffalo though, so hopefully this is a sign. Maybe this is what we're going to be playing with in the beta, which by the way, the beta is a very, very small 4 days away now. On Tuesday, the beta will be releasing. Very exciting. We're going to talk a little bit about that later on into the video. Whilst I do prefer and find a buffalo to be a more exciting animal, I do think it struggles a little bit more when it comes to the comparison with its real life counterpart. Now, I haven't picked the most exciting buffalo I could find, I promise you. I found a lot of Cape Buffalo that actually look further away from this one in reality, and I'm sure there are some lovely buffalo out there that look kind of like the one we've already got. The problem with Planet Zoo's Cape Buffalo is the kind of lack of variety. If we go back to the Gemsbok, you can see in the patterning in the face and in the lower body and in the horns and everything, it's an interesting animal to look at in terms of the patterning and colours. The buffalo is just black all over, the same shade of black. It's just black, 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 black everywhere. There's no hint of patterning, there's no hint of coloration. Not that they should add a magical pattern to the animal, don't get me wrong. But if you look at actual Cape Buffalo, a lot of them have faded patches of fur and scars, or just general wear and tear on the bones, and the bones feel, you can kind of see it's got this ragged patterning there on the horn, and it is there on our actual, on our Planet Zoo variant, but the horns are sort of a little bit darker, whereas here they come across a little bit lighter. You can see here it's quite a light grey and it fades down into the black of the snout and the face. Even the snout itself is a more prominent sort of pinky colour than it is here. Inside the ears is more prominently pink than it is in the Planet Zoo variant. It feels like the Cape Buffalo could do with a little bit of love, just making it a little bit more interesting, giving it a little bit more variation, particularly in colour and texture. Otherwise it might not come across that exciting. There are more exciting buffaloes out there as well. This is not the most exciting one, although it is a lovely photo. Anyways, still very excited about the Cape Buffalo. Maybe this is, you know, the game isn't out yet. The game's not out for like a month and a half yet. We've got a little time to see some changes. You never know. Other than that, though, the Basil model looks great, and that's what's really important. Before we move on to the Reddit AMA, recently there was a brand new trailer released for Planet Zoo. This is for the beta. Now, we saw the buffalo in there, we saw the Gemsbok in there. Generally speaking, it was a lot of stuff we'd already seen. However, and I am going to put the trailer in this video. It'll be at the very end, so just wait around to the end, able to watch the trailer live right here in this video. Don't know why it's live, but let's just pretend it is. There was this scene right here, and this got people a little excited. This got me a little excited, because right there, ladles and gentle spoons, is a baby Gharial, and it's adorable. Let's just make that a little bit bigger, shall we? Bam. Okay, that doesn't really help. But I mean, yeah, we're gonna take him back smaller. It is painfully cute. I have a big thing about the Gharial. This is my favourite animal in the entire game. I got to play with it myself when I was over in Gamescom. It was very, very cool. I think he really sticks out. And this is the kind of animal that excites me. And just seeing that teeny, tiny little baby Gharial was really cool. You can see another one over there. And if you watch the trailer I mentioned at the end of this video, then you'll see them swimming and live and moving around and stuff like that. Very briefly, we don't get a good look at them, but they're there, right? It's another baby to add to the collection, along with the other cutest babies, which is, of course, the Tapias. In terms of new animals, that is about it. But I'm going to bring up a big red screen for a dramatic effect. Bom, bom, bom. We're going to take a look at the AMA results now. And they've got five different quotes to talk about here. Let's look at the first one. This was posted by Wolverick91 over on the subreddit. Now, this one is, I would say, a little bit of a negative, I'm afraid. So they asked, are there going to be any mammals or birds in the exhibits? The exhibits are, of course, closed glass cases. Birds and mammals did seem unlikely. And Bo confirmed it is only reptiles and creepy crawlers that we're going to be seeing in those exhibits. So that's the arachnids and stuff like that that we've already seen. A little hurtful to call them creepy crawlers, but I'll get over it. And that's okay. That's kind of what you'd expect. Like I said, they are big glass cases. You're not really going to expect birds or mammals in that kind of environment. It would have been nice to see maybe a mesh variant that then came with birds or came with mammals. That would have been pretty cool. My worry about this is we haven't seen many very small mammals. We haven't seen, you know, meerkats or prairie dogs and stuff like that. Stuff that you would typically see in a zoo. We do have lemurs. Lemurs are very small in the game. But other than that, we don't have that many small ones. And I'm a little bit anxious that we're going to miss out on a lot of those. Kind of the Jurassic World Evolution problem, where we only just got to these very small dinosaurs with the Homolocephali. I'm a little worried those are going to be neglected because we're not going to have mammals in these exhibits. That's not for definite, and if those animals can be implemented and brought into exhibits and stuff like that, and they're not ignored just because they're not in exhibits, then this is not a problem at all. It's just an interesting piece of information for now, really. The second one, posted over on the subreddit by Mjin Manella, who I believe I've quoted in regards to something else before in the past, who knows, confirmed that there will be some cheats from Planet Coaster, making it over to Planet Zoo. Of course, they're in the same universe, and they're built on the same engine, and the same base, and stuff like that. The main one, and one we've been curious about, is Tejid Cam is making it into Planet Zoo. Now, for those who don't know, Tejid Cam is a little cheat in Planet Coaster. What you do is you select a guest, you rename them into Tejid Cam, and that gives you, like, a first-person guest view off the park. It's not an ideal solution in my... I've got to be honest. I'm a little surprised this has made it in again. I'm a little surprised we don't have a dedicated first-person view. I think if you took Tejid Cam and edited it a little bit and just made it its own camera mode, that would be a much better solution. I don't know why this is the solution that they're going with yet again on what is a sort of a sequel in some ways. That does surprise me a little bit, but at least we will have a first-person guest view being able to walk around the park. They have also mentioned they're going to add some more post-release, possibly. They've got lots of ideas, cool suggestions from our community. What else could be added to Planet Zoo as a post-release cheat? Or your animals can fly, or or your guests become protesters and have a real rumble in the bat cage. I don't know, you know what I mean? It's going to be more interesting things. If you think back to JPOG, you had some boring ones like More Money, but you also had a cheat that turned all your dinosaurs into zombies. So that's the kind of thing I would be hoping for. Next up is one that I went and grabbed, and this was about the rides and tours and stuff like that that are going to be present in Planet Zoo. Are there going to be more? Now, they've announced the steam train, we've seen that, and the wildlife tour, that's the jeepy, trucky looking thing that carries you through the exhibits. Definitely gets you eaten by cheetahs, by the way, I don't know how that works, but still. There will definitely be a few more rides when the game launches, with their main function being transporting guests around the park. It doesn't sound like we're going to have viewing galleries and underground domes and all this kind of stuff quite yet. It sounds like all the rides are going to be function related, and that function is going to be travel. There's not going to be, say, roller coasters and stuff like that, or like fairground rides. It's going to be very much about travel. What that does mean, since we've already got truck GP sort of thing and we've already got the train, is what else? Well, what else are you going to see? I think we could definitely see a hot air balloon sort of ride. I think that would suit Planet Zoo quite well, that kind of whimsical kind of nature. And how else are you really going to transport people around the park other than the two we've already got in the game? I'd love to hear some suggestions about this, because other than a hot air balloon, I'm kind of struggling for answers a little bit. A speedboat. Next up is this one right here. Now, first of all, somebody posted on the subreddit and took this to be a hint that the red panda is going to be in the game. I don't know how they've read that way, because that's not what it suggests at all. Somebody called RedPanda1316 posted and said that red panda was their favourite animal. Bo says, what a surprise that it's your favourite animal. Because, you know, it's called Red Panda. I suspect red pandas might make it into the game, although the fact that they live predominantly in trees is going to be a problem, kind of like with the sloth. But this doesn't confirm anything. I don't know why this has been read into at all. What she does say that's interesting is that, of course, this right here. So basically, in the beta, we're going to get franchise mode, which I'll talk about in a little bit, hopefully. I'll talk about it right now. Franchise mode is basically you make a series of zoos, they're all called the same thing. It's kind of like building a franchise, you know, like a McDonald's, for example. And you get to trade your animals between zoos and build like this brand, essentially. So that's going to be available, and a scenario. You're going to play one level from the main campaign. That's going to be available at beta launch as well. There will be no sandbox in the beta. However, when sandbox does come in with the main game, it will be available from the very start, no unlocking required, and animals do not have to be unlocked. So unlike Jurassic World Evolution, where you have to four-star every island now to get everything, or you had to research the dinosaurs in the past, instead they're going back to how it was in Planet Coaster. Everything is going to be available to you right from the get-go in sandbox mode when the game launches on the 5th of November. Which is pretty cool news for those who like that. Personally, I kind of like unlocking things for sandbox, so that's a little disappointing for me. But really, it's better that it's available for everyone who wants to be able to get in and just mess around with that rather than the campaign. The final thing we're going to take a look at is this response here from Bo once again, and that is simply that the sandbox map in Planet Zoo is the same size as in Planet Coaster. Now, that's actually a pretty good size. People have made some incredible parks in Planet Coaster. Do we want bigger ones? Of course, we always want bigger ones. But it is worth mentioning that the majority of animal exhibits will be smaller than a roller coaster. You know, if you've got a lemur exhibit and stuff like that, or lots and lots of these other smaller animals, you don't really need mass amounts of space. You're definitely going to maybe want to make like a safari zone kind of thing, a savanna with loads of animals in a big wide open area. But generally speaking, are you going to do that for all your animals? Not really. So it should mean we can get some really big, really good size zoos when the game comes out. And that's it, folks, for new information. Now, random little tidbit at the end. I will be, of course, streaming the Planet Zoo beta right here on the Best in Slot channel come the 24th of September. I think probably the 26th or something like that. Next Tuesday, I think I'm allowed to talk about this. I'm pretty sure I'm allowed to talk about this. I am flying out to San Diego, courtesy of Planet Zoo and Frontier. Very, very excited. Big thank you to Frontier for flying me out there. Super excited. I don't think I can tell you what I'm working on quite yet, but I'm pretty excited to get started with it all, and hopefully you guys will see that content down the line. That's all I can say. But either way, I will be bringing you some Planet Zoo streams as well, live from TwitchCon, which also happens to be going on next week, live in San Diego. So big week, lots of stuff. I'm going to have tons of Planet Zoo coverage right here on the channel as soon as anything happens, I promise you. And yeah, I'll see you lovely folks next time. Let me know what you think of this stuff in the news down below, in the comments down below. I should have said if I spoke English correctly. And hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.